I'm Lieutenant Governor Sue Alsperman, and one of my additional roles is Secretary of Agriculture and Rural Affairs. In that capacity, I've had the opportunity to interact with a number of young Hoosiers involved in the FFA organization. This past year, the Indiana FFA state officers and I were discussing the importance of agriculture education in all schools, whether in the middle of an urban neighborhood or surrounded by acres of farmland. An interesting conclusion from our visits was that much of modern agriculture curriculum met the definition of science, technology, engineering, and math, or as we call STEM education. At the end of our meeting, I challenged the state leadership team to develop a marketing plan that would demonstrate the value of adding agriculture to a high school curriculum and show how that subject matter would support the goals of increasing STEM education. There are successful examples of school systems that saw the light and added agriculture studies to the curriculum, but there are a great number of administrators and principals who I hope will consider this message. This video makes the case for agriculture education through comments from students, teachers, industry leaders, and others involved in agriculture. I ask that you listen carefully and thoughtfully. You may want to make agriculture education part of your curriculum or strengthen your existing program for our students and the future of our state.
We've got to double down as a society, and certainly in agriculture, on STEM. And to be able to think that we can teach a student about biology through agricultural principles, or teach about physics. Certainly a lot of mathematical applications are so core to STEM, I just think it's a natural as a way of applying the principles of STEM.
Agriculture education is important for all students because it affects their lives in three ways. In the classroom, where they're learning the content, with the supervised agriculture experience programs, where they're getting real work experiences, and FFA, you know, they're building those relationships. And in education right now, they're looking at the three R's: rigor, relevance, and relationships. And FFA provides the rigor in the classroom, the relevance with SAE out in the workforce, and those relationships that go on for a lifetime in FFA.
We know that students in agriculture education are entering college and even the job force with knowledge of crop and soil science, of plant science, of animal science. They're able to run the math on how to make a return on investment. They come in with so much more knowledge from hands-on experience, which applies directly in real life, that sets them heads and shoulders above the competition.
We have been able to incorporate our curriculum with the science, as well as introducing technology, engineering, and math skills across the curriculum, and we have seen some wonderful results with this. With our students, not only are they getting those practical hands-on skills that we offer in our agricultural curriculum, but we're also seeing a rewarding side of everything from test scores, improvements, to being able to become involved in the classroom.
You know, agriculture is the first ever applied science curriculum, and it's been around probably the longest in the high school programs. You know, we're teaching the science, teaching that technology, teaching that engineering and math in all our courses, from agribusiness management to landscape management to agriculture, power structure, and technology.
Agriculture's all around us. Last time I checked, most of us eat 2 or 3 meals a day, sometimes more, sometimes less, and I think that is agriculture. So the importance of understanding agriculture in its broadest sense, where food comes from, how it is produced, is very important.
Agricultural education is just so important. America was founded on agriculture, and our agricultural industry is the largest and most advanced, and America does agriculture right. And so it's important for our citizens and just people, and whether you live in a small town or in Indianapolis, to know about agricultural education, because it's basic knowledge that everyone should know. It's food, it's what we eat.
It's not your father's ag program, it's not your father's FFA, and we have kids in our ag program that have never stepped foot on a farm, and it helps them to become more well-rounded as they get out in the real world.
An agriculture education student comes out with the application of so many of those science, technology, and math skills that are absolutely very valuable to them as a consumer, but also valuable to them as an employee.
A lot of people don't know how advanced agriculture is. They don't know all the different aspects of agriculture, especially in towns and urban areas where they don't really think about it.
I think a student in agriculture education does have the leading edge in education today, because you can take a student who considers himself to be the average student and be just as competitive as that person that's ranked number one in a class, because they're able to learn the fundamentals of agriculture. As I've always said, the production side of it, the cows, the plows, the sows of agriculture, but at the same time, that student can relate to the cells, dells, and gels that's taking place in the science department, our math department, the technology department, in our schools.
I cannot tell you how frequently I go back and rely on some of those fundamentals of STEM techniques, STEM principles. Even though I'm in the middle of government and a lot of policy work, a lot of that policy is dependent on our biological systems.
We've recognized that there is a growing need for STEM-related career fields, and certainly supporting that in the high school and the college curriculum. Over a third of the roles in the pharmaceutical industry directly tie to science, technology, engineering, and math. Less than 30% of high school graduates are prepared for college curriculum in STEM today. And we know that there's a forecasted 3 million unfilled science jobs in the United States by 2018. There is absolutely no time like the present that we need to inspire and encourage young people to start in high school with STEM education. And I think agriculture education is a prime place where that can be a beginning point or a continuation of their passion for science, technology, engineering, and math.
Testing in our school has to be enhanced by the fact that our students are in the Ag Ed program. We have currently this year our valedictorian and our salutatorian both come from the Ag Ed program. Both are involved in FFA, and the fact that they've been in that program has helped them because of the access to the science, technology, engineering, and the mathematics.
I took an ALS animals class, and then I took an AP biology class, and during my AP biology exam, I would have to say I used more of what I learned in the ALS class than I did in my AP biology class. So I could see instantly different areas that I could apply it to, and it was very exciting for me.
We can take an objective, a standard, and say, okay, you know, this is the definition of it in the science world, but how does this really apply in the real world? And that's where agriculture education has been able to take it to a higher level. And we've been able to take students to reach into an angle that they've never thought of as a career choice. And even that non-traditional student who may not ever go to a four-year degree, but they got those career readiness skills. One of the neatest areas that people don't think about in agriculture education is the research. There are proficiency award areas where students can do research projects that will allow them to keep data and information.
I think your basic courses are so test driven now and so standard driven that it's always that we're worried about what you're going to score on a test to graduate or to get an AP score, that the agriculture classroom is the last avenue where students can really break free with creativity and explore things and really investigate and learn from those experiences.
From an outside perspective, I think that administrators need to challenge everyone with the reality that ag education is much more than just agriculture. It's about science, technology, engineering, mathematics, and it's even about the English and language arts and communication, and there are so many things that you can do within that program that it's going to help you whether when you go to college or go out to get a job in the real world. We'll